name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate an experiment through which we may determine the impact of sodium chloride on the boiling point of water as we create multiple solutions of varying molalities. For the experiment, we're going to need only two materials, deionized water or distilled water, and plain salt or sodium chloride. On the equipment side, we will need four beakers. We are going to need a hot plate. We'll need a thermometer that is able to go to above 100 degrees Celsius. I will be using three weighing boats, but you could use the same if you are measuring the same chemical over and over again. And I will use a scoopula if needed. And finally, a scale. We are going to prepare very similar solutions to the ones that we made to perform the experiment on the freezing point depression, enhanced by the addition of sodium chloride. So if you have those solutions ready, you may simply move forward with those, place them on a hot plate, and then you're ready to go. But if you are only focusing on boiling point elevation experiments, then you may want to start your experiment like this. Remove the lid of your scale, turn it on, and then in your first beaker that I marked as deionized water, we're going to place that on the scale, tear, and add 50 grams of deionized water. I have 51.58 grams of water. It shouldn't matter because a boiling point is an intensive property and the amount of water that we are using to determine it should not be important at all. However, to maintain the consistency of this experiment, we're going to use approximately the same amount in grams. Next, I'm going to move on to my second beaker, tear it, and measure out another 50 grams of water. I have 49.85 grams of water. And I labeled this beaker with a label that says 5 grams of sodium chloride because that is the amount of sodium chloride I will add to it in just a little bit. Next, I will place my third beaker on the scale, tear it, add 50 grams of water to it. And I am very close at 49.89 grams. This one will have 7.5 grams of sodium chloride added to it later. I will place my final beaker on the scale, tear it, and then transfer 50 grams of water to it. This is just a little bit over at 50.79 grams. This one will eventually have 10 grams of sodium chloride added, hence the final label. And now I will measure out the amount of sodium chloride that will be added to each one. I will place my weighing boat on the scale, tear it, and then transfer 5 grams of sodium chloride to it. I have exactly 5.00 grams of sodium chloride. I will place it next to the beaker in which it will be transferred. Next, I will add a weighing boat on my scale, tear the mass, and add 7.5 grams. It is a little bit over at 7.68 grams. This will go in my third beaker. And then in my final weighing boat, I will measure at 10 grams of sodium chloride. And I measured 10.04 grams. With that, all my mass measurements are complete. I will set my scale to the side. All my chemicals have been selected and measured, so those can go to the side, and I can move on to making my solutions. First, I have my pure liquid, which is the water, and I will place that on the hot plate, and I can start the heating. The heating should be set at a low medium or medium temperature so that it doesn't go too fast. Next, I will combine my 5 grams of sodium chloride with the water. I may swirl it a little bit, but typically heating the water is going to help dissolve the sodium chloride faster. So I will place this also on the hot plate. Next, I will transfer my 7.5 grams of sodium chloride in my third beaker. Set the weighing board to the side. I can swirl my solution a little bit and then transfer it onto the hot plate. And finally, I will combine my 10 grams of sodium chloride with the approximately 50 grams of deionized water. I will swirl this a little bit, careful not to cause any of the water to spill, place it on the hot plate, and then wait until it begins to boil. It has been a while since we started heating our deionized water and our sodium chloride solutions of various molalities. In this case, we're going to monitor the boiling point of all of these liquid and mixtures at this point. So we are going to begin by establishing our baseline, and that is determining the boiling point of simple water. We're going to take a thermometer that measures temperature at least to 110 or 120 degrees Celsius. And in the first step, we're going to submerge the bulb of the thermometer inside the beaker with deionized water. We want the bulb to be fully submerged, but not touching the bottom of the beaker. And then we're going to give it at least a minute or so for the temperature to go as high as it can. The temperature of our boiling water is 99.2 degrees Celsius. Then we extract our thermometer, wipe it, careful because it is hot, and then move the thermometer into our first solution that contains the 5 grams of sodium chloride. We follow the same process, insert the bulb of the thermometer inside the solution, but don't touch the bottom of the beaker. And then we leave it there for at least a minute until the temperature goes as high as it can. The temperature is currently at 102.0 degrees Celsius. And we're going to give it another 30 seconds or so and check again. And we'll see if the temperature has stabilized in that range or if it is still going higher. The boiling point seems to be holding stable at 102.0 degrees Celsius. We will extract the thermometer because we don't want to wait too long, as the more water boils, the more concentrated our solutions become, and that may impact the boiling point of the associated solutions. We're going to repeat the same temperature collection for the other two solutions with sodium chloride, and then we're going to determine the boiling point elevation dependence on the concentration of sodium chloride in the solutions. Because all these beakers are currently very hot, at the completion of our experiment, we should turn off our hot plate and ideally wait until all the beakers cool down enough so that we can touch them without burning ourselves. However, if you are short on time, it is best to use tongs and place the beakers on a heat-resistant surface. That may be your countertop, if it is a chemistry lab, or it may be a wire gauze that will allow you to remove your hot items without burning the surface on which they are placed. The most important though, anything that your beakers that are hot will go onto should not be wet.